Forever.
Amen.
You became man for our sake and were baptized in the Jordan River. You became the way and the door that leads us to the Father. Grant us your grace and mercy, and accept the fragrance of our incense, that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, forever. Amen.
To obey Christ. We are ready to punish every when your obedience is complete. Look at what is before your eyes. If you are confident that you belong to Christ, remind yourself of this, that just as you belong to Christ, so also do we. Now, even if I boast a little too much of our authority, which the Lord gave for building you up and not for tearing you down, I will not be ashamed of it. I do not want to seem as though I am trying to frighten you with my letters, for they say his letters are weighty and strong, but his bodily presence is weak and his speech contemptible. Let such people understand that what we say by letter when absent, we will also do when present. Praise be to God always. Alleluia, alleluia. No one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. John, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the Word of the living God.
The apostle said, "The next day John saw Jesus coming toward him and declared, 'Here is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. This is he of whom I said, after me comes a man who ranks ahead of me, because he was before me. I myself did not know him, but I came baptizing with water for this reason, that he might be revealed to Israel.' And John testified, 'I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it remained on him, and I myself did not know him. But the one who sent me to baptize with water said to me, "He on whom you see the Spirit descend and remain is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. And I myself have seen and have testified that this is the Son of God.'" This is the truth. Peace be with you. Superhero and had all kinds of imagination of what kind of person he would look like, what would it be like to really meet him. He sounded so powerful and so forceful, and absolutely confident in what he had to say. And then they actually met him, and they realized that his personality didn't always line up with what he had to write. And there's kind of several different explanations. If we use our imagination about anything that we write about, we can, somebody else has write about, we can create our own image of it. And we can be more brave when we're writing and we're not seeing the people right in front of us. This is certainly true that we see over and over again on social media, like Facebook. People take might write things in too quickly and really regret it later on. But I think you know what I mean, that sometimes we can be not authentic when we write, because we can get away with that. But when you actually see the person speak, it has a different influence. And it's not to say that Paul was a fake or didn't represent what he wrote, but they could see his humanity in the midst of it. And that's important for all of us to remember, that Jesus sees our humanity and knows that our words don't always line up exactly. We promise and we make wishful thinking. We say we'll never do it again, and we know the right answer. And how often have we said, yeah, I know it, for somebody who's pestering us? Or not pestering us, maybe they're really actually sincerely doing it as an act of love to correct something that we're doing. And we'll say, I know it, but that doesn't always mean knowing it means we will do it. And that brings us to the gospel. You know, here, John is Jesus' cousin. John wasn't even born and was leaping with joy when Mary went up and visited Elizabeth for 3 months. Neither one of them were born, and yet they knew each other. And that's, on one hand, if you only want to look at the surface, that seems contradictory. That can't be true. Well, we can certainly translate and interpret things in such a manner that we can make it untrue. But to have this be true, we would have to go deeper into our understanding and research and pray about and look for answers. And unfortunately, another human attribute is that if we already have an opinion, very often we are not open to an interpretation or an email link that shows that what you believe is not true. The list goes on and on and on of the different ways that we think we know, but we don't know. And this dynamic between John and Jesus isn't quite in that area, but that it certainly is to point out that these two cousins didn't get together and say, oh, wouldn't that be neat? We could create another religion, and we could make millions. Whoops, we picked the wrong century for that. But that's not what happened here. It wasn't them coming up with their own stuff. It was both of them, in their own way, according to their personality, in the way that they were called, to reveal more fully the revelation that happened in the Old Testament. Not to dismiss it, not to get rid of it, not to make fun of it, but to know that everything that is written and everything that we are meant to believe isn't static, it's living. That it is supposed to be transforming and changing and developing towards a more wholesome, more healthy, more accurate, more truthful way of understanding who God is. And believe me, we can certainly have very false ideas about who God is. I remember reading a little Bible story to this little boy one time. And he looked up at me and he said, you know, Father, I know your mother's name. And I go, uh-oh, what is this going to go? I said, what is it? He says, well, don't you know? And I said, well, I just want to know if you know. He said, Mary. And I said, uh-oh, I know where this is going. So that means you know who my dad's name is. He said, of course I know. It's Joseph. thought I was Jesus reading the story. Of course, he was inaccurate, and it was easy for me to convince him that I wasn't. But it shows that as we develop and as we grow, so does our faith. So there's many people who have rejected the church or rejected God because they were challenged in a certain way. Maybe it was the humanity and the imperfections of the others, and choose not to want to associate with them. And that reminds me of a phrase that's in the Epiphany liturgy. It's in the hymn. We didn't use it today in saying, "I will lift my eyes," which is beautiful. But there is a little expression in there. When the waters knew that Jesus was going to go into the water to be baptized, they surged forward. Now, in our mind, we might think, you know, being at the lake and all of a sudden all the water just wells up and comes at Jesus all at once, you know, and I think that's fair enough to do. Probably didn't happen, but they could justify splashing the other person when they come to the water, get them wet faster than they want to. Not that I would ever do that, but the symbolism is there. That is very powerful. The water represents something that's pure and cleansing, and it would be our instinct that when something that is not nice, maybe distorted, or ugly, or filthy, or dirty, or smelly, to want to draw back away from it. Wouldn't that be awful, but it'd be funny at the same time, you know, if you were in sin, the water would hurry up and move away from you. But that's not the purpose. The purpose in God's grace and Jesus becoming human, for him to offer himself on the cross, wasn't to be able to figure out who of us were so bad that he could pull away from, but just simply telling us, "I know who you are, and like the living water, I will move towards you." And the wonderful thing about water is that it envelops you. And that is also very powerful in the way of the Holy Spirit and the understanding of Jesus. That when we are in need of cleansing, and John the Baptizer certainly preached repentance, and our need for repentance also is attached to this something inside of us that something is not quite right in my life. Something is going wrong. I'm making decisions that make me miserable when at first they made me seem very happy and very intelligent. So we go to the water, and the water envelops us. And think of that in your own way, in your own spiritual life, in the way that you look deep inside of yourself, that it isn't God's desire to pull away when he discovers it. Of course, he already knows, but he is hoping that we will discover it, that he wants to come surging to us, for us, and to surround us with, in some prayers, it says a fatherly embrace. In today's liturgy, it's the living water that Jesus went into, sanctifying it. That the best thing that can ever happen to us is to see God in these ways. Not to deny who we are, not to be afraid of who we are, but to know whoever we are, we can go into the water. And not to get away with it, but to know that we've done trying to get away with it, that now we want to face the truth. Am I lovable in this situation? And can I be transformed? Can I be changed? We wish it was like a magic wand, but grace is not a magic wand. It is our life. It's constantly saying yes, trying to pay attention to when things aren't going right and what's the remedy. And as the light gets stronger and the surge gets stronger, we may notice other things that come up. in our life that we were afraid to deal with, and maybe it's time to deal with it. So that's why John can say, I don't know him, even though I'm sure they knew each other very well. I can't imagine cousins not knowing each other. But we are human, and we are constantly learning to know ourselves better and knowing one another. Ask anybody who's been married. They know that the other can surprise them even when they think there are no more surprises to be had. And it's also in the relationship between parents and children. We surprise one another because we are uniquely our own. Each one of us discovering, wanting to be known, wanting to know what we can do to find favor with God. And it's simply just to say, yes.
Substantial with the Father. Through him all things
brought to you out of the love for you in your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and a place for their earthly gifts. Grant them life in your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ in his plan of salvation for us, we call upon this offering of those of things God commanded to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, Saint Mary, Saint Joseph, and Saint Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered for Kathleen. Remember also all those who shared with us today in this offering. Amen.
Thank you.
dwells again, metexehumetia, usolio ave wahaye, dalamomi.
Amen.
O caro acos orum sigo, men habero, amen, magios,
Savior of all. We pray. pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the civil leaders throughout our country and throughout the world. Enlighten their consciences to bring security and peace to your people. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for peace throughout the world and an end to war and all acts of violence and hatred. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the Holy Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, St. Joseph, St. Jude, St. Marin, and St. Charbel, and all the saints, assist us through their prayers and make us worthy of their reward. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the righteous fathers and teachers who have gone to their rest among the saints. Remember those who diligently carried your gospel throughout the whole world and confirmed your holy church in the true faith. Assist us through their prayers and strengthen us in your love. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and a consecrated life to serve the Maronite Church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Favorably remember, O Lord, our parents, brothers, sisters, teachers, and all the faithful departed, here and everywhere, who have gone to the rest, especially Kathleen. Forgive us and forgive them of all sins and offenses, through our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is without sin, and hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant
us
those of us who have departed, and forgive the sins we have committed.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us and the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and all things, with the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and your living Holy Spirit, now forever.
through trials and temptations that we do not have the strength to overcome, but deliver us from every evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of it, and receive the blessing of the Lord.
O Lord, bless your worshipers who bow before you and adore you. Make them worthy of your mercy and forgive their sins. For your almighty and rich in compassion, we raise glory and thanks to you and your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most High Trinity, eternal and consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth, to him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness
There's been a change in my schedule. I wish I could tell you I won a trip to Hawaii and could not come back until the snow is gone. But that's not true. I'll be coming back. I have to do a funeral on Monday, the 16th, for Charlie Joseph. May he rest in peace. And I think, is there a... What is today? I think there's a collection today.
Yes.
For fuel collection. So, second collection for fuel. But I will be back. I fly back Friday. But I do have to make the retreat, so, but I come back Friday. So I'll be here next weekend. Hara and Father, we may have to wait till another weekend to come for me. We thank you, O Father, for this gift that you have given us, though we are unworthy. Do not shame us because of our sins, but help and save us, that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your only Son, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lord Jesus, stretch forth your right hand and bless your people. Protect them by your cross. Be their shelter and refuge, and perfect them with your abundant blessing, that we may raise glory.